These are the only images that exist of this catastrophic event. But this sequence was not shot by a video camera. Instead, it was created by USGS scientists and graphic artists based on a series of extraordinary still photographs taken by an amateur photographer named Gary Rosenquist. On May 18, 1980, he was standing 10 miles away from the mountain next to local resident Keith RONNHOLM.
He was on a tripod with a motorized drive and just was and took a very much time-based sequence. I don't think he was trying to make a scientific record, but it turned out to be a very good record of the event, and I know it was used by many scientists to try to time the event and to measure how fast the landslide occurred.
The landslide, the explosions begin and they get very large very quick. So it helped to understand what had happened.
The first frame of the Rosenquist sequence was taken at 8:32 a.m. and 21 seconds. It reveals an intact volcano. But what the image doesn't show is what was happening inside.
Magma was forcing its way up into the volcano, and to make room for itself was starting to shove rock aside. So there's this rock sliding across each other that was causing some of these earthquakes. It wants to get out somewhere, and the north side seems to be the weak side. And it starts bulging there. It just looked like a big, bad blister on a tire.
Inside, the earthquakes and superheated magma have forced the north wall of the mountain to collapse. The second frame is taken 26 seconds later, capturing the weakened north flank and summit. The video morph shows the mountain collapsing into two huge landslide blocks. 6 seconds later, Gary's third photo shows the top landslide block as it begins to plunge down the volcano. The sequence depicts its movement at nearly 200 miles per hour. Still frame 4 shows the landslide after it has removed the north flank, depressurizing the magma and boiling groundwater. The video morph reveals a series of sudden, violent explosions of gas, steam, and rocks. This is known as a lateral blast. Gary's final frame is taken about 15 seconds later. The lateral blast accelerates to 336 miles an hour, completely obscuring the landslide.